Shiva, what are you doing there? I think I found out the truth about the Archons. And what does it look like? You tell me. That makes sense somewhere. What? With the spiders. Why? Because human beings have three eyes. Three? Human beings get two physical eyes and a third eye. And which animal has more eyes than humans? Which animal sees more than humans? One with four eyes. Hello and welcome to the Matrixer. This is Shiva and Jonathan. Our topic today is about arachnoids and the truth about it. Alright, we don't know it for 100% at the moment, but we give you some evidences that speak for who just put us in here, has lured and captured us in the Matrix. Yes, as I said in a previous video before, I was in a very high dissociative state of consciousness. Suddenly I found myself being in a kind of cocoon, a kind of shell. I called it the matrix shell, or you can also call it a membrane shell. But I think the term cocoon hits it also very well, because I touched the structure of this shell and realized that it is very elastic and very fibrous. And the only thing in the manner of an association was really a spider cocoon. So that's the clue I have discovered. And as we said before, I could see that every person is in such a shell. That means in which he is watching this all-day reality right now, on the inside wall of the cocoon, like a panorama cinema, you could almost say. And the point here is that I often asked myself how I came into this cocoon and how the human beings at all. I know it. But I tell you later, as soon as I can talk. Yes, and then we just dealt with it and talked about it. And of course we have tried in higher states of consciousness and within hypnagogic states to find out more about this cocoon, what it is and in which I found myself there again. I talked with some people too, people I talked who had maybe a similar experience, and it was very similar. They told me that sometimes they feel like there is something around them, a kind of shell also. You know that too, yes. And then I also met a woman on a workshop I give sometimes, and then she told me as a child she always painted eggs with spiders on them. And I find that a very interesting association. For this reason, the question is, of course, for us, how did we get into this cocoon? And why does a cocoon got this unique skills that you can perceive the all-day reality inside the cocoon? An exciting question. Why are around 99.9% of all people afraid of spiders? Or got a spider phobia or disgust in spiders? Yes, even if you see maggots, yes, that is for the current aesthetic eye not the optimum. But you are not afraid of them or anything else. But with spiders, it is yet another story entirely. Hardly anyone likes the spiders. Yes, that's right. Many are afraid of spiders, or at least have a great respect. Yes. What have you experienced to the spider? You noticed a lot of, even more in hypnagogic states. Yes. I just get this morning back from my dreams, and there came Bo, my cat Bo, and wakes me up with his rough tongue in my face and scared me a bit. But in this moment of fright, I went hypnagogically again and saw the arachnids. After that, I was so scared, I had a pulse of 950 afterwards. Bam, bam. They were so scary. Those were definitely an artificial intelligence, so inorganic beings. They were very robotic. They looked very metallic to me. It was a big army. There were thousands of these metallic spiders. They are also not as small as our familiar spiders here. They were as big as we are. So huge metal spiders, very, very dark and creepy feeling. Yes, because they looked very inorganic. They weren't even semi-organic. Mariella on YouTube recently also has done a video about it, about the spider creatures, with the translations of Simon Parks. He also talked about it. You can also take a look at it. And in this context, I saw these spiders. I saw these spider creatures today, but I also had dreams of how we got into this cocoon, and also by the spider beings. It wasn't all on the physical level. That was very 4D, at least, no idea. I can't even guess. I think these arachnids were a different breed, because they were at least 10 feet high. The cocoon are at least 7 feet in circumference. That means the spiders have to be very big. They were very big, very long, thin legs. Yes, I saw that they have taken souls and transferred them into a finished cocoon, I would say. Everything seems very floating. You as a soul have been put in this cocoon. I only saw the cocoon from the outside. I was just an observer. I was relatively far away as an observer. I could only see it that way. And there we were drawn into this cocoon, and it actually looked very spider-like, as you perceived and saw it too. And as I said, that wasn't on the third dimension, but probably on the fourth dimension. And I don't know in what contact these arachnids stood with this army that I saw. They probably already belonged together, probably. My feelings, my first association with this tells me that these giant spiders who put us in this cocoon created this additional inorganic robotic army, because that were really a lot just to scout or doing something. So they really looked not very friendly. So the feeling of something who assumed that the spider robot army was really rather dark and not benevolent, I would say. So those were my two experiences. I've dreamed of spiders before, but unfortunately I don't remember that. But now these are the main experiences of how we were put into the cocoon, and these were the spider beings. And now the question is, why could we as a soul be caught in it at all? Or why don't we get out of there? The question is, what was caught there? That is the question for me. So about the true consciousness is outside of the shell, so inside the shell can just exist the soul part that was taken. This means the one we play here on Earth, because we are in the cocoon and watch. So we are not really sitting here, we only pretend that we are sitting here. That's why I would say it is the soul part that we are here, with all of our exposed alternative reality selves. Yes, I still remember once when I was in the cocoon. So not that I dreamed it or something, but that I was really in it within my waking reality. I was sitting at the table in my living room at home, and I just dissociated there. And the moment I dissociated so much that the reality around me has dissolved. And suddenly I was in this cocoon and I just put my finger through it, through the cocoon. So it was very, very elastic. I stretched the material for so long until it suddenly clicked and I came through with my finger. I felt a huge cave behind it, a cave. I felt a real huge cave behind it. Also that I somehow noticed that I was apparently in some cave and that I am in this cocoon. Yes, I also noticed such a cave. I have seen a picture once. I also saw cocoons in a cave then. However, there were a lot of cocoons in it. They all were in that cave. Yes, but I also had the impression that I am not alone. So I had the impression too. So that would be an indication. Yes, we already have a few indications. Therefore, I think that's a mega exciting topic. Yeah, there are not many people who have seen or perceived it that way. At least I don't know many. A spirit healer, a friend of us, has noticed and seen it on her mental travels. But otherwise, I really know very few who saw something similar. So that's all evidence, but since dreams are actually in alternative realities, and it has been shown to me by my higher selves, so I assume that's true, because what I don't believe is that my higher self would lie to me. Yes, that's right. It doesn't lie, never. Yes, and in my case, I really perceived while being awake, and we are sitting there, I perceive this cocoon around me. And the material of it, and that I sit in there, and that I saw my whole familiar reality on the inner wall. So I saw everything clearly, and there is nothing for me to doubt. And you can't convince me otherwise that anything else could be right. Me neither. Because observer dreams are for me very, very present. They are always very clear for me. So when you dream something as being an observer, you're always very active in it, I would say. So for me, it's very clear that it's true. So I think this is phenomenal accordance, what you have perceived and what I have perceived, because I always ask myself, what kind of cocoon is that? What is it really made of? And what is the substance of which the cocoon is made? It is really quite a lot of knotted or spun fibers, really as if someone had tinkered the cocoon with a loom. And in terms of size, it can't have made by a normal spider either. Not the spider that we know, more like a tarantula, a very old movie maybe, if you remember. From Lord of Rings in the third part, at the end with Frodo, that was also this kind of a huge spider, more like that. In this direction, just a lot thinner, not very nice. You said they were very long-legged, so for me, seen from my perception, they are highly intelligent beings, absolutely an artificial intelligence, as I would call it, ice cold, completely emotionless, yes, a predator character. No, not even, because they have a kind of creep. It's like a robot. Just in a really creepy way, like Terminator, only in a really creepy way. You know that when you see, if you get into altered states of consciousness, and then you perceive these artificial intelligences or these worlds with artificial intelligences, so I think they always seem very creepy. That's how they act. Highly intelligent, and not just a few of them. I think that there are really many. It's a really big army they have, a really big population. So an AI. Yes, for me it was an AI and a robot. That means the spider creatures that captured us were also AI, but they created these other spider creatures additionally. At least that was my impression. That would make sense, at least in our everyday life, an explanation for a spider phobia, because psychologists are still wondering today where this spider phobia can come from. Though the common interpretation of psychology is that somehow you were in a bed as a toddler, and then toddler said, "Mom, there is something on the wall," and there was a fat spider, and the mother went there, killed it, and said, "That's something really gross." That is the basis of psychology. That the reaction of the mother and the disgust that the child felt from the mother jumped over the kid. Yes, but where did mom get that from? That's the next question. I agree. And you can say, yes, she got it from her mom again. And that mom of her mom. But who started with it? That's the question. I believe this feeling is stored deep in our cells. This does not necessarily only come from mom. No, I don't think so either. And that would be an explanation now. Because based on this evidence, we currently have, it almost looks like this to me, as if we are on any one unknown planet, I agree, in some big cave with lots of cocoons in there, 4D, at the 4D level. And in each of these cocoons sits a person and dreams his everyday reality. So that's the bottom line for me that I see there. The question we asked ourselves, why do you have to get on to get out of there? Tell me again the example with the astral planes, with the prisoners from hell who are supposed to go to the mental plane. Oh yes, we have already spoken about this, about the astral plane, and there are in the lower astral planes more or less closed areas of realities, respectively reality simulations you can enter. For example, I always call them heavens and hells. Because in one there are more heavenly conditions, which are based on any belief systems, and these hellish realms, they are also based on any, yes, very uncomfortable belief systems. For example, there is one hell in which something like Lucifer really lives, who somehow tortures people there or grills over his fire or so. Or there are realms of reality by that you are not even know that you're dead and you run around there all the time and you still try to live and defend. It can also be a hell. Or the Jehovah's Witnesses also have their own reality areas. Then that is a heaven, because they are all very nice to each other, but there they live their belief system. And if you just come down from the higher level to get someone out of the lower levels, it may happen that you fall back, because your frequency is still shaped to the lower realm range. Then they do it like this, that the personality they are trying to bring from the lower plane to the middle astral plane will be enclosed in a cocoon, so that you no longer will be pulled back to the lower areas. And then they wait until you have adjusted again to the frequency of the middle plane. And then you come out of your cocoon. So that's a common method there. But I didn't see any spiders there, I have to say. Were the cocoons similar? Were they so spinous, or were they more ethereal? So they were more energetic. So they weren't made of fibers now, or like this, but they more were pure energy balls. But the principle is the same. It's just like with a chick. The question is simple now. If we are in the fourth dimension, so I had a near-death experience, I was on sixth level, eighth level or whatever, and actually I'm wondering if we're included on the fourth dimension in the 4D. Why do you have to ascend after 9D, so to speak, to get out of there with your consciousness? Because obviously you can't just go out like that. Otherwise, I think a big misfortune will happen, because I have the impression that you cannot just get out of the cocoon if you're not far enough developed, I would say. But 4D isn't exactly 90. That is another question that is still open to us. Would you like to philosophize about it? But you also meant the cocoon feels quite physical. Therefore, it cannot float around in 9D. No, it feels very physical, I have to say. It is almost as if the cocoon were around us, but in reality slightly out of phase, so that you can't see and feel it. But when you get into the state where you can perceive it, it looks and feels totally physical. Yes, true. So it must be in the fourth dimension. Then why do you have to go up with your consciousness so fast? So far, i.e. increase the frequency so far that you can just climb up to get out of the cocoon? For me, that is a question too. Well, the matrix ends up at 9D. It's not like that. But yes, these are questions that still concern us. We are on it, for sure, because that's one of the most exciting topics for me, ascension and the cocoon, because it hangs very close together. So completely actually, so much for our topic today. So who actually captured us in the matrix, really? Which beings could have been this? So not to be confused with the genetic engineers, the Anunnaki, who created us here as we are sitting here now, but rather the ones that originally actually cocooned us into the matrix. So these are still two different alien races, and they did two different jobs. Yes, the Anunnaki make the booty bodies, the organic suits, and the spider beings apparently have somehow spun soul parts from us, or even somehow more. We don't know that. Yes, also to get yourself to perceive yourself within this cocoon, that requires a very high state of awareness. So you don't even see it just out of nothing. Somehow you have to dissociate very, very strongly. And in this context, you have to expand your perception extremely, otherwise you don't see it. Maybe those of you who know who have already used drugs or mind-expanding substances, and you may have perceived such a shell around you, and you somehow felt like you were sitting under a bell, or something would have been put around you. These are all signs for that, I would say. But maybe some of you have perceived something like this, or maybe someone has any additions to tell that would help us and to find out more. And yes, we definitely appreciate comments, and maybe the one or the other one has suggestions, or more importantly, if, of course, you have experienced something similar, or you have had similar perceptions in whatever condition or under whatever substances. Yes. That's it from the Matrixes for this week. Until next week. Ciao. Ciao. Ciao.